Obamacare has been around in one form or another for over 3 years now, and most Americans still don't know what it means for them and their families. That included much of Congress.
But we have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it.
Betsy McCaughey, however, read it and understands it. In her new book, Beating Obamacare 2014, she spells out how to brace ourselves for what's ahead.
Over half of Obamacare is paid for with cuts to Medicare, mostly what Medicare pays hospitals.
One result, hospitals will cut back on nurses.
So no matter what age you are, if you're going into the hospital, be aware you're going to get a lower standard of care. And when you press that button for help, you're going to have to wait longer.
So if you know you're entering the hospital, you could hire a private duty nurse, at least for the first night or two.
All the doctors, especially surgeons, but generally all doctors, keep a list of private duty nurses they prefer. The hospital also has a list of agencies with which they deal, so the nurses they call will be very familiar with the routine of that hospital.
Those Medicare cuts will also hit individual doctors, as their reimbursements for treating their Medicare patients will drop. So plan ahead.
If you're in your mid-50s, late-50s, early-60s, line up your doctors now, a cardiologist and an internist, even if you're healthy. Because if you don't, when you turn 65 and go on Medicare, you won't be able to find a doctor willing to take you on as a new patient.
We all confide things to our doctor that we wouldn't tell anyone else. But under Obamacare, doctors enter all that private information in a computer.
And recent headlines highlight the problem that private information on the web can fall into the wrong hands.
You ought to talk to your doctor about keeping two sets of books, so that there are certain things that just stay in that office. That's the way it always used to be when doctors kept paper records. And just give your doctor a heads up. Your doctor will appreciate it, because doctors take the Hippocratic Oath. And that oath means keeping your confidences private.
This year, an estimated 25 million people will lose the health insurance they have through work. Employers won't be able to afford the new small group plans that contain all of the benefits the government requires. So don't be caught off guard.
Go talk to your human resources division now, or your boss, or if you're just part of a small group, talk among yourselves and find out whether this is going to happen. There's nothing worse than being clobbered by surprise.
If your company insurance goes away, you'll need to budget more for health care.
Be aware that if you are forced to go to the exchange, you're going to pay much, much more and get less in return.
It might be cheaper to choose coverage that doesn't meet the government requirements and pay the penalty.
Talk to an insurance agent and see whether that's a viable alternative for you. For example, if you try to get high deductible insurance or a plan that doesn't meet the 10 essential benefits but has everything you want.
Although Obamacare is the law of the land, McCoy says it's not too late for a motivated Congress to repeal it.
Then in the future, when we have better people in Congress, replace it with targeted help for the uninsured. And you know what that will do? It will leave the rest of us alone.
And finally, McCoy says people of faith need to fight back.
This law is part of a much broader, and I'm sad to say it, a broader assault on our ability to worship. And not just worship in church, but more importantly, to practice our faith in our everyday lives. There's a big assault on religion. And I think we have to take a stand at this point and say, if you like your God, you can keep your God.
Lori Johnson, CBN News.